Right, hello YouTube. As you can see, I've had an haircut and a shave, and I've got a new t-shirt. So it's I thought I'd just come out and do a bit on the bike now. So one of the things, if you've been watching the channel, you've noticed that I've had a bit of a dilemma as to what soft luggage to use. I originally bought some Lomo's roll bags, pannier bags that sit on the side, and they get improved to be okay for me. They're a great product, but they're not okay for me. So what the problem was that when they were fitted on here, they were so heavy, they were falling inside into the wheel arch. They probably need some kind of pannier racks fitted to the bike, which was something I didn't want to do. So I've got rid of them. They've been on eBay and got sold, and I'm now going to bought a different set of soft luggage, which I think is going to be better for me. Now the challenge that I've had is been able to try and find some soft luggage that will fit onto the rear seat. And be able to be easily removed when I come to do a refuel, because if you're familiar with these bikes, you will know that the petrol tank is located under the seat, or you need to lift the rear seat, and I'll demonstrate that later. So the version that I've bought is, and I've only bought one bag just to give them a go, is the Rhinowalk Modular system. And what they do is they come in three sizes. They come in a 10 litre size, a 20 litre size, which is what I've bought, and a 30 litre size. And what you'll see from the description here, you can get all this from their website. It's all readily available. You can configure them in a number of different ways, and the bike, a bag fixes to the bike, and then other bags and fixed to that. So the main selling point for me was the fact of these straps. So what you get is in effect is eight straps that come with the bike, and these straps which turn it into a rucksack should you wish to use that. But what you get is a little sort of strap here with a loop in. I don't know if you probably can see that. There's a little loop there, and a buckle, and a strap here. And as you can see, I've fitted some to the bike already. They will fit round here, and you'll see how good I am with doing this type of stuff, which is not very good at all. All they do is they'll fit through this buckle. Everybody's used these types of things before, and then it will pull tight. And it creates a fixing that is quite unintrusive. I like to just double them back through the buckle just to make sure that there's no slippage. And then all I then do is just tuck the waist underneath, and you'll see. But anyway, I won't muck around with that at the moment. You can see how tidy you can make them. So you end up with these four loops. And what then happens is these buckles here, which have this quite nice aluminium hook on, and just a normal plastic bayonet type connector that fits to the bag, and that slots into there, and then this will slot into the bag, and you're able to then tension this up and down to be able to keep that. So the idea being is that when I come to do a refill, I can either just unclip this and take the bag off, be able to lift the seat, and then it's a quick four sort of bayonet connections in to make that, connect that to the bag. Alternatively, I can just loosen that, unhook this, and then just re-hook it up. So that's why I bought them. We'll give them a go and see how they go. So the bags themselves, and I've installed this. So what you've got, the bag itself is a roll bag, a typical roll bag. If you've ridden a motorcycle or done any diving, you'll know what it is. It rolls up to keep it secure. And I didn't know this until I received it, but it's got a zip out and waterproof lining, which is really quite good. So if you've got muddy boots and things like that, you can take this out and wash it, and it's not going to protect the back and not ruin the bag. So that was a good feature, which I didn't realize it had. It's just a cavity. There's nothing special in there. What you then get is on top of the bag, there's various sort of strapping fixings, and the idea being is that when you get your other bags, these fit in to that bag and create anchor points, And there's quite a lot of them about to be able to decide what type of configuration you need. And that enables you to then strap bags on top and bags on the side. So the little loops here enable you to put that in, and then you can start to fix bags on the side. Like I say, I've only got the one bag. I'm going to give it a try and see how it goes. And then potentially, if it works for me, I'll do that. So all that then happens is with these is, that's not going to be one that's okay. Right, so you roll the bag up, that hooks into there, and then it's just a simple case of strapping that down. And this one will go here. You've got the idea. It's not rocket science, and you can be able to strap that down. And I'll just put this one on just because I just want to show what I plan to do at a refuel. So these look into there. So interestingly enough, this bag come with a lot more features than I first thought it had. So it's got this zipper here. And that allows you to get access to a little pocket at the top, which is quite handy. That, so if you've got this fixed on the bag and you've got stuff in there, I know we've got the frunk at the front to keep a lot of stuff. But if you do have stuff that you need to get to handy, that's quite a nice little feature there. Also on the bottom of the bag, and I don't understand why it's on the bottom of the bag. You have this this netting thing here, so you could put stuff in there if you needed to, and that probably enables you to configure the bag in different ways. So there you go. That's it really. If you've ridden the motorbike and you're looking at this video, you're probably familiar with sort of soft luggage, and you know how it works. But it's the mounting system that I'm really interested in. So the idea being, those hooking those little caveats there, it tightens up. You can obviously adjust them and tuck all this away so it's nice and neat. And what the idea being is that when and this will obviously be rolled up, the idea being is when I want to do a refill or refuel even, is I can unlock the trunk, clip those two off, move the bag to one side. Yeah, the bag could hang down, or I could take it off completely, and then I can do my refuel as normal. Drop it back down again. Re-come over, bring these up. It'd be probably better with some stuff in there, and lock it up. So that's the plan. What I'm going to do is I'm going to load some luggage into this. As you can see, the weather's not great today, so it probably won't be today. Try to get out over the weekend with some luggage on, see how this moves about and distributes. I might even put an hose on it to see how waterproof it is, and we'll see how it goes. And then, like I say, I'm thinking it's going to be successful, and then if it is, I'll look to potentially buy the 30 litre bag, which will go on the centre. It's basically just a bit wider and a little bit longer. And then another one of these, and they will fit on the side, and that will give me this configuration here, and that should be more than enough. So we'll have 30 litres and 240s, it will give me 70 litres worth of luggage, plus I've got the frunk. That's going to be plenty for me, I think. We'll wait and see. But what I'm interested in first is how it's all going to move around, and we'll wait and see how that goes. Anyway. I'm reasonably pleased with this. In terms of value, really super good value. This bag, I think, was, I can't remember, it was £36-£37 off of Amazon. It turned up on Prime the very next day, so that's good. The 30 litre bag, I think, is 41 and some pence. And so that's a bit more expensive. And if you want the sort of fluorescent colour, the yellow ones, they're a couple of quid each if you want that, but I've got enough fluorescent gear, so I won't be doing that. But we'll see what they've got in stock. Anyway, there you go. I'll post an update once I've had a time to test it properly, and we'll see how it goes. And hopefully this is going to be good. And when I do my next trip, which is planned for the 20th and 21st of April, we're going to go and do the ABR route out to Aberystwyth from Wales. I will be able to use it in anger. And I'll give you some proper feedback. Anyway, thanks a lot and speak to you soon.
Bye.